her in the kangaroo cat suit, brushing out her hair, looking at the mirror in the bathroom, planning out a trip to fantasy, fade the rather plain and mundane, cue the absence of gravity. There's a forest made of colorful trees, every branch of them covered with bees. They make a sort of swirling collage, shifting like a mirage, nary an eye that can dodge, but wait, you see something lodged in every abdomen stripe, kind of a sugary swirl, twinkles ever so tempted to our little girl. She goes to make the approach, tiptoe, no hustle, every muscle is tense, every tiny step a shuffle, enter Bobby the bear, got his paws upright, blocks Sakura with his fuzzy fairy bear might. She doesn't know what this is all about, but then a deep and friendly voice blurts advice right out. He says, "Don't eat bees, 'cause bees are not for eating, but they're for, well, they're for making honey. Don't eat bees, 'cause bees are not for eating, but they're for, well, they're for making honey." Sakura in the kangaroo cat suit, sitting at the dinner table munching down some fast food. After eating her lunch, she gets the urge to explore. Gravity vanishes once more. We see a field of grass, every strand made a yawn. It's some kind of farm, you can tell by the barn, with a dozen pink sheep and a chocolate fence. Sakura can't resist, eats the door, and that lets all the sheep out. Now they wander around, there is something the farmer just cannot allow. He gathers his flock, Sakura tries to help. That's when she notices the sheep have a fruitier smell. Maybe the wool cotton candy, she has to be sure. Sticks her tongue out as she dips towards the pink wool. But then the farmer tells Sakura to step away, and when she asks why, she hears the farmer say,
"Don't lick sheep, 'cause sheep are not for licking, but they're for, well, they're for being bully. Don't lick sheep, 'cause sheep are not for licking, but they're for, well, they're for being bully. Don't eat bees, Sakura. And don't lick sheep."